A question that I get asked a lot is, why aren't patterns in my standards? I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and I hope you'll stick around as we investigate where are the standards about patterns in the math standards, as we work to build our math minds so that we can build the math minds of our students. So the first thing to know is that there's a couple of very important pages in the Common Core standards that shifted patterns somewhere else. So whether you're a Common Core state or not, it kind of played a role in even your own state standards. So if you're not familiar with it, the Common Core state standards has a couple of pages in the very beginning that are called the Standards for Mathematical Practice. Those standards, there are 8 of them, and those standards are where patterns got shifted to. Now, if you want more information about the standards of mathematical practice, I've already done a couple of posts about them, and so click the links below to get more info if you're not familiar with them. But for this short video, we're just going to talk about why they got moved over there. The main reason is because the looking for and using patterns is something that should be done at every single grade level. So the standards of mathematical practice are things that kids should be doing. They're like mathematical habits that we want kids to be doing from kindergarten all the way through into as they get into college. So we don't want patterns just in kindergarten or just first grade. There are things that kids need to be looking for at every grade level. So if you take a look at the standards for mathematical practice, it's numbers 7 and 8 that talk about looking for and using repeated reasoning and looking for patterns. Now, the hard part of those mathematical practices is that they're kind of written in general terms for kindergarten all the way through 12th. And so if you want a little bit more detail, there was a wonderful document that was created that was called the Elaborations of the Standards of Practice. And they were for kindergarten through 5th grade. Like, what do these actually look like for a kindergarten classroom? Because sometimes they're written, you're like, okay, I don't know how that really applies to my grade level. So one of the links below will link to my vlog post that was about the standards of mathematical practice and the elaborations that are specifically for elementary school. So the big part that I want you to understand about patterns is that you may not have specific standards at your grade level, but that does not mean we shouldn't have kids looking for patterns. It's just not something that we're doing specific lessons on. These are things that we should be doing every single day. We want kids looking for repetitions inside of mathematics and then using those to help them look at those patterns and use those patterns to help them solve problems. So if your state standards do not have patterns, you've got to still be helping kids look for and use patterns, because it is a huge part of the standards of mathematical practice. And even if your state is not using those, they're just great mathematical habits that we want kids to get into. All right, I hope that this video helps you build your math mind so that you can go build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.